Today we want to simplify radicals, and let's start with one of our most favorite, which is square root of 25. And when we write this radical symbol, we want to know what number multiplied by itself. Hopefully remember that 5 squared is 25, so our square root of 25 is 5. We sometimes like to make it more exciting by putting in some letters. And when we put in our letters in elementary algebra, we call them variables, of course. And we always choose that our variables are non-negative. So we're going to choose that throughout our little video here. And sometimes it just helps us think, okay, if we've got to keep things here exactly the same, that 49 is usually comfortably 7 times 7, a squared is comfortably a times a, and then b to the 4th, either we might remember b squared times b squared, or if we get stuck, we can think 1, 2, 3, 4 b's, and there's our b squared. And so whatever is the same is what comes out, and so here we get 7 a b squared. But just as we don't limit ourselves to just squaring when we do exponents, we don't limit ourselves to squares when we do radicals. I think which number I want in there. There we go, I want 27. So this little number here is called our index. The number inside is called our radicand. And here, instead of saying what number multiplied by itself, we want what number multiplied by itself. Three times. Because our index always tells us how many times we're going to multiply something together. And so we might think, well, 27 is 3 times 3 times 3. And so there's our 3. So if we switched and did this with our 4, we call a fourth root of 16. We know that 2 to the 4th multiplies to 16. So the fourth root of 16 is 2. So we simplified radicals that were perfect squares, but radicals aren't always perfect squares. So we have a nice simplifying property that helps us simplify radicals that aren't. So we use that a square root of x times y is the same thing as a square root of x times a square root of y. Again, we're still assuming x and y are non-negative. And so we could start, for instance, with our square root of 12. And here we're often thinking about having our perfect pieces in one and our not perfect pieces in the second. And so sometimes you can just do it without too much trouble. 12, one of our favorite factorizations, is 4 times 3. 4 is a perfect square. 3 is not a perfect square. 4 times 3 still multiplies to 12. Square root of 4 we know is 2, and we get 2 square roots of 3. And radicals are considered more simplified when their perfect factors are out. Again, we might like them perfectly fine either way, but this is considered simplified, and that is not. So we can also make them a little bit more interesting. So here we could have 5 times the square root of 48. and it often helps to just start, know that this is multiplication and use your parentheses. Again, we're interested in breaking it up, but 48 often doesn't come with a perfect square to mind. Or we might think about 4 and 12, which is not quite what we want. So I often like to just choose to get these all the way down to primes. And I like to keep thinking about keeping these the same. And then I often know that I'm going to have something left. We look, how many twos do we have? We have four twos. So I could use two and two. My three doesn't have a match, so it would be left over. Here, we know that this 4 times 4 is 16. Our leftover is 3. So here's our perfect piece. Here's our not perfect. Square root of 16, we can see we've already got set up as 4. Now got 4 times the square root of 3. And here where we're multiplying, we often think about insides and outsides. We can multiply outsides together, but the insides stay the same. So this is really 5 times 4 times square root of 3, which is then 20 square roots. Let's now simplify square root of 18a to the 4th b cubed. And let's just factor 18. And we're going to think about perfect and what's going to be left. So we know we're going to get 3's, a 2 left over. A to the 4th, we can do a squared, b cubed, we can get 1, 2, 3 b's. A b left over. So we know our perfect piece, 3 times 3 is 9. A squared times a squared is a to the 4th. B times b is b squared. And our not perfect is 2b. Square root of 9 is 3. Square root of a to the 4th is a squared. Square root of b squared is b. And our not perfect piece stays alone. You can always multiply to make sure you haven't left anything that you shouldn't leave, but there we have it simplified. So now we want to be a little different. We want to simplify a cube root instead of a square root. But the basic things that we do are still exactly the same. We're going to prime factor our number. This time though, we want to think about breaking it up. We want three pieces that are the same, and think about what's left. We can see we have 3 threes. So left is going to be our 2. We have 4 x's, so we can use 1 on each, 1 left over, and then this y is y cubed. Is perfect. So we break it into our perfect cube, our not perfect cube. 3 times 3 times 3 is 27. Here we get x cubed. There we get y cubed. And left is 2x. When we simplify the cube root of 27, we know we're getting 3. Cube root of x cubed is x. Cube root of y cubed is y. Our leftovers stay the same. Everybody tends to forget the little index, so sometimes if it's a nice cube, make yourself a little note and double check that you still have your index when you finish.